Good decisions come from experience, and experience comes from bad decisions. Third molar extraction is one of the most frequent procedures in oral surgery. 10 million teeth are extracted from approximately 5 million individuals every year in the United States. The reported reason for third molar removal include the risk of impaction associated with the caries, pericoronitis, periodontal defects in the distal surface of second molars, odontogenic cyst, and dental crowding. A prospective study showed that general dentists recommend extraction for a third molar in 59% of patients, mainly to prevent future problems, or because a third molar had an unfavorable orientation or was unlikely to erupt. However, the power to predict third molar eruption is low, and impacted third molars that remain static with no changes in position or angulation over time are rare. The ideal moment to determine whether or not to remove a third molar is also underdeveloped, since impaction prediction has not been scientifically proven. Moreover, it is a daunting task to predict this biological condition with any degree of reliability. Systemic reviews report that there is no evidence to support or refute prophylactic removal of asymptomatic impacted third molars, even in adults. However, in comparing the opinion of orthodontists and oral and maxillofacial surgeons, it's become clear that later indicate prophylactic removal of third molars to prevent crowding more often than a former. However, indicating extraction of third molars, dentists should have adjustable reason, one that takes into account future treatment planning from an orthodontic, surgical, periodontal, or prosthetic point of view. At the same time, a cost-benefit analysis should be carried out to justify the prophylactic removal of third molars, which should only be indicated with a purpose of preventing cases that involve pathological processes, such as root resorption or caries in the second molars, cysts, and pericoronitis. Furthermore, dentists and patients must take into account that surgical complications after third molar removal are common. The prevalence of seeking post-surgical emergency appointments is around 10%. The reasons are severe pain, swelling, bleeding, alveolar osteitis, abscesses, dehiscences, sequestra paracentesia, hematoma, and trismus. Although uncommon, there are hundreds of reports on jaw fracture after third molar surgeries published in literature. These fractures predominantly occur in a patient who are older than 25 years. Thus, it seems reasonable to believe that postponing the extraction of third molars increases the risk of mandibular fracture. On the other hand, third molars can be used to replace a first or second molar previously extracted. Also, because stem cells can be delivered from healthy human third molars, they represent an easily accessible source which opens a range of new possibilities for regenerative medicine. For orthodontic patients, the decision whether or not to remove the third molars could be postponed until the end of orthodontic treatment, except for situations in which the removal of third molar is mandatory since the beginning of treatment. A follow-up evaluation of third molar position during treatment can be contribute to be a more realistic decision for prognosis of these teeth. If orthodontic treatment is complete before the final positioning of these teeth is achieved, the patient should be reassessed by a clinical examination and periodic radiography. In general, not deciding is the best decision for such cases. Thank you for watching.